Hello everyone, Liev Sosa here. I hope you're having a great day today. And when it comes to weight loss or weight gain, what genes have to do with it, right? So that's it, the title of our video today. That's what we want to talk about. And that is, you know, basically because when we are born, we do carry a certain genetic risk to go into a process of fat storage, right? But what else is at play, you know? From the point of view of genes, we can have access to more precise information to understand our behaviors towards food. So today I will share three examples of genes that are involved in controlling our hunger impulses and desires. So the first one is the FTO gene. And FTO is the fat mass and associated obesity gene. So it actually plays a significant role in weight gain and obesity. Approximately 42% Caucasians, 5% and Africans, and 21% Asians carry risk variants. And the FTOA allele is associated with low satiety. So that means that I cannot stop eating. It is also related to increased appetite and desire to consume energy-dense foods like fats and sugars, and desire for continual snacking, making satiety the main problem, and is not really associated with low metabolic rate, which could also be another cause of weight gain. So next gene is called the leptin receptor, the LEPR. So the leptin receptor, leptin is actually a hormone and a neurotransmitter that regulates in our brain that allow us to be aware that we have had enough to eat. So leptin is produced also, is it produced by the fat cells and is highly correlated to how much fat we store and the actual size of the cells, of the fat cells itself. Obesity is characterized not by a deficiency in leptin, but a leptin resistance. So there's too much high leptin and the receptors are saturated and blocked. This is a result of elevated cortisol, also chronic stress, eating too frequent meals, too many, and more rarely some genetic mutations. The last SNP or polymorphism that is important in controlling our hunger is called the MC4R, and that stands for melanocorticotropic 4 receptor. So after a meal, the body senses, you know, like high energy levels, stimulating the I don't want any more signal. So this sends a signal to leptin and insulin to increase the production of a hormone that binds to the MC4 receptor, signaling, you know, satiety. That means we have had enough to eat. So if this said, you know, if the receptor is not properly configured because of some polymorphisms or SNPs that we call when we do our genetic testing, then we can understand that if you have certain tendencies towards food, the reason why, and we also have tricks about how to go around that. So on the other hand, when the body senses low energy levels, it stimulates the release of ghrelin to release another peptide that binds to the MC4 receptor, stimulating hunger. So if you are struggling with overweight and you cannot control it, it is definitely not your fault, and it is possibly related to your genes. So it's just, you know, like it's not because you are a bad person, and you have to know that you are not alone. You know, there's a lot of people that, you know, feel that way. So I think that knowing this information is very powerful for us to understand what's going on in our bodies to make the right choice about eating or not eating according to whatever will give us the best health outcome. That is what is important. So it is also very important for you to know that you know, I have a lot of polymorphisms on those genes, and I have been overweight in the past, but your genes are not your destiny. Genes can be turned on and off according to your environment. And, you know, it's also very important your support system. So if you want to learn this information about yourself, then book a discovery call and let's get you tested. Bye. Thank you for watching.